My director of public health has advised me that allowing evictions during a pandemic is simply bad public health policy. Turning residents out into the street now before they have access to federal funds could keep them in their homes or to protect them. It's just not wise. We can't forget the important strides we've made in our cautious reopening. I worry that an increase in cases linked to evictions could be a big setback in those efforts. So today I'll be asking the St. Louis County Council to pass an emergency ordinance to stay evictions by fully implementing the CDC's latest eviction moratorium. Thus far in the pandemic, the circuit court has stayed all evictions, but in recent days, the court decided to allow some to move forward. We shouldn't let that happen yet. As a county government, we have a role to play here, and I'm asking the county council to help us stand up for our friends and neighbors facing evictions. Talking with council members over the past few weeks, I know that one of the priorities for the new federal funds coming into the county will be helping people stay in their homes with rental and utility assistance. But our ability to help those people doesn't have to wait on the new federal funds. We can start right now. So I want to thank Congresswoman Cori Bush for her work in refocusing us on all of the challenges that our most vulnerable folks in our community face. She has reoriented the conversation here in St. Louis County and increasingly around the country. The people of St. Louis County already have a lot to thank Congresswoman Bush for, starting with the new federal funds that she secured for us. So I'd like to stop here and turn it over to Congresswoman Bush.
Thank you and good morning. Thank you, Dr. Page, for convening these weekly press conferences. It's so vital to our county to have this time with you. And thank you for inviting me to join you this morning. Our teams have been working closely together regarding the looming evictions crisis in St. Louis. And I'm grateful for the opportunity to partner with you to ensure our residents are protected through this public health crisis. This is a crisis happening in our community and across this country, in our world. And we have to make sure that our residents, that our community members, our neighbors are supported. I've been evicted. I've been unhoused. I've been forced to live in my car with my two babies. I know how destabilizing and violent an eviction can be. Being evicted where I didn't even have the money to go to the next place, putting my items, that removing them with trash bags. I couldn't even afford the boxes. It can ruin lives and cause irreparable harm in the lives of the children and families who need our help the most. It's a trauma that I would not wish on anyone. We are making significant strides in expanding the availability and accessibility of vaccines, but the circuit court's decision to resume evictions would undoubtedly set us back. And we're coming together to emphasize our shared goal of keeping people in their homes. The science is clear. Kicking people out of their homes during this pandemic has led to hundreds of thousands of additional COVID-19 cases. It is deadly and it's dangerous. St. Louis can do better and we must do better. As public servants, we must do the absolute most that we can to protect the health and the safety of every single resident in this county. I'm proud of the work we've accomplished in Congress. We passed the American Rescue Plan, a historic $1.9 trillion package that included over $700 million for St. Louis local governments and $27.5 billion nationally for emergency rental assistance to help millions of people stay in their homes. 2 weeks ago, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention extended the federal moratorium on evictions because the federal government has recognized that displacing people from their homes during a pandemic will only worsen this global health and economic crisis. St. Louis County needs to follow suit. And so I'm thankful for Dr. Page and for the council being willing to make this happen. I want to be clear that the people of our community should not be getting a knock on their door being asked to prove that they qualify to stay in their homes. I urge our community to reach out to our office. Reach out to my office. Call us if you are at risk of being evicted from your home. Our government must not allow any of us to go without shelter during this public health crisis. I am proud to join Dr. Page today in affirming the basic right of shelter to all St. Louisans. And I'm hopeful that our work together will lead to a moratorium on evictions for as long as our communities must live through this public health emergency. Housing is health care. And I'll say that again, housing is health care. And it's a fundamental right that should be guaranteed to all, most especially during a time of crisis.